started really, really soon. We're having some slight technical difficulties with our stream, but we're going to, as soon as we're ready to go over there, hopefully in about 30 seconds we'll be going. It's nice to see everybody in here tonight. This is a packed house. Hopefully the air will kick in at some point, so I apologize for that. It's nice and cooler this afternoon. All right.
That guy's like a high school. Oh. from? That guy's gonna be like 10 feet tall. Oh my god, it's my sister. That kid's like a mega senior.
I was gonna say,
he's a football player. I've missed Oh, yeah, it does. Yeah. Is that Mr. Mullen? That is, back there. Back over there. Bro, Mr. Mullen is cool, yeah.
I'm Dr. Blood. Let's get started. Good evening, everyone. Honored guests.
Thank you.
Vergara. Congratulations. Award winners, please stand this time. We also have four silver presidential award winners. Please join me in recognizing Camden Polarecki, Maylene Perez, Chris Tetler, and Charlotte Butler. Now we have four awards to present to students, recognizing their hard work and valuable contributions they have made to MMS. Please stand and read your names. Daniel Avila, Matthew Colwell, Ellie Newman, and Sean Yuza. Congratulations to all our award recipients. Great job. I will present our first award this evening on behalf of the McHenry Elementary Education Association. These awards were voted on by the MMS faculty and staff to students who deserve special recognition for their leadership, kindness, enthusiasm, integrity, among other positive character traits. These students have definitely made their mark on MMS and have made their teachers proud. Drum roll. Yeah, well, this guy, I'm sorry. My bad. Please come forward and I read your name. Addison Enoch and Drew Borcher.
Kiwanis Merit Award to Ian Bailey, and Samantha Rydell.
Change your way of thinking when your world changes, and my world changed a lot. I went from taking a bus to school every morning and sitting in a classroom with my teachers and classmates to turning on a computer and doing most of my assignments independently. I had to learn to adapt to an entirely new environment where I couldn't ask questions. And I couldn't ask questions because, well, not because, you know, nobody knew any answers, but because that is why I didn't ask questions. Nobody knew any answers. No one knew what to say or when to say it. No one really knew what was going to happen. And that's scary. Because when we're growing up, we're told that if we have questions to ask, then someone will always have the answer. But now nobody had the answer. Everyone still had questions. So we learned to live with the unpredictability of change. We adapted to this whole new concept of life. And finally we decided if this was going to happen to us, if the world was going to change on us, we had to change too. We had to be able to thrive in a world that we knew nothing about. And that was the moment we started to grow up. The moment we realized that this world is never going to revolve around us. And for a kid, that's scary. Growing up is scary because kids are selfish. And growing up means being mature and helping other people. Most of all, means becoming more than yourself. And what I mean by that is when you're a kid, it's just you. The whole world revolves around you. When you're a kid, tell you about what you want and what other people can do for you, how they can help you succeed, how they can help you be better. But eventually you realize that that isn't how the world works. At some point you realize that this isn't about it. At some point it stops being what can they do for me, and it starts being what can I do for myself, or what can I do for them. And that's growing up, realizing it isn't about you, that you aren't the most important thing in the world. And you either accept it, and you do your part, people that you care about, and the world that you live in, or you never accept it. And you stay in that mindset of what can they do for me? You never grow up. If you don't accept that this world is unkind and unpredictable, you'll never. part of my middle school experience on a screen. It wasn't exactly what I had in mind. I'm almost glad I did. Because if I didn't, maybe I wouldn't be here today, giving this speech to all of you. I'm not saying it was easy, because it wasn't. And I failed. A lot. My first day of seventh grade, I almost had a complete meltdown because I couldn't find a link to my first class. Trust me, I was here. I'm all sorry. But that's normal, because failure is normal. And everyone has failed, because no one is perfect. If you think you are, you're wrong. You failed, so have your parents, and your friends, and your bosses, for those of you that are graduating today. The point is, everyone who knows failed, at some point or another. Because failure is part of life, and life is unpredictable. There is always, always, always going to be failure in this world. Because the world doesn't stop for anything. It doesn't take breaks, and it doesn't slow down. It's just like life. You might not be able to change the world, but you can always change your life, because it's yours. And it's up to you to decide what happens next in your life. But if you want to take what I'm saying, a grain of salt, go ahead. I'm just some random 13-year-old girl. Or maybe I was a child, and my entire world flips upside down. And now, because of those experiences, I've grown up. Maybe I do know something about what I'm saying. It's all up to you to decide what you want to remember this. But if I can leave you with one thing, don't let who you are stop you from becoming who you want to be.
Thank you.
My brother and I were home the entire year of 7th grade. Even when we had the opportunity to go back, we did. A lot of people always ask me why. From my own experience, I can tell you that I didn't go back because I didn't need to. Being online didn't change my concept of learning. It didn't change the fact that I was interacting with my teachers, but most importantly, it didn't turn me into an antisocial person. Some of us need our friends in order to stay focused and motivated. It doesn't matter what kind of person you are, as long as you don't change yourself in order to please other people. You are amazing.
We are all put in a position that no student I know we all can get sick of it. But I just wanted to show all of you that COVID, aside from the sickness part of it, was actually a blessing in disguise, even though it wasn't a welcome surprise. There are many surprises to come in your future, some of that stress you may not welcome. But the most important thing is to take some time in your life to feel like yourself. Watch some TV, eat some pizza, and just relax. And the reason you do this is that it is way harder to focus and try your best at school when you have added stress at home. I would also highly recommend that each of you get involved in some sport or activity in high school. I was involved in cross country and basketball here at MMS, and it really helped me declutter my mind. And I made some good friends along the way. Albert Einstein once said, "It's not that I'm so smart, it's just that I stay with problems longer." This one really spoke to me because in class, I am often defined as being the smart kid. And that has always bugged me a little because even though I appreciate the compliment, it really didn't speak to my full potential. Yes, I have gotten good grades, but what level of intelligence do grades really speak to? I mean, I believe that grades are really a symbolization of grit and determination. That is why I'm staying here. Not because I am so much smarter than all of you, but because I have the grit and determination to keep going when things get tough. And you all have that ability. You just have to channel it. I believe that potential is useless unless you have the courage and grit to unleash it. While school can be challenging and stressful, there is always a silver lining to any problem you may come across. You just have to look for it. The silver lining in this scenario is that me and my sister both had to do a speech, and I was happy that she was there with me. My sister and I both been super competitive all throughout middle school. She and I would always have math tests on the same day, and we would always ask each other who got them, because we always wanted to one-up each other. And now that the final tallies have been scored, it is very upsetting to me that I am not going to be crowned the smartest sibling. You know, school is often presented as a boring place where kids learn boring stuff, but I want to credit our amazing teachers for really breaking that ideology in the past years. I want to thank my teachers for making learning fun for us. I remember a couple of times this year and last year when my teachers and I just talked about a TV show they both liked. My mom heard me on Zoom one day talking to my teachers about the show The Office, and let's just say she wasn't pleased. Speaking of my mom, I would like to thank her and the rest of my amazing family for supporting us all throughout these years. They are huge supporters of our education and sports. They have made school and life so much easier. Before I end, I would like to take a moment to thank Dr. Glover, Mrs. Barrett, Mrs. McGann, and the rest of the administration for all that they have done for this school. Andy Bernard from The Office once said, "I wish there was a way to know you were in the good old days before you actually left them." And that's how I feel about leaving MMS. You know, I would say good luck, follow your dreams or whatever, but we still have another 4 years left. So I guess see you then. Thanks.
Seeing you grow physically, some of you are way
taller than me now. I've seen them grow socially, even though the dinner dance wasn't quite what I expected. I thought it'd be more dancing than just standing around. But you guys get there. And also academically, I think you've taken great strides and you're ready for high school. Their growth is an example of why I believe we have one of the best middle schools in the state of Illinois. If a student of McKinney Middle School is willing to listen, actively engage in all the lessons here, they will become a better person and will be prepared for high school. Their achievements are a testament to the hard work they have done in the classroom and the activities they participated in. It's also a reflection of their families. And also the teachers who had to adapt on the fly throughout the past 3 years. What I've seen from the class of 2022, from the first day of middle school to now, is an impressive example of what outstanding young people can do when they push themselves to do their best every day. At this time, I want to extend some heartfelt thanks to our families. I hope you enjoyed your experience here. Thank you for your time and your commitment to your students' education. I'm sure there were nights you were up late doing homework, throwing a meal in the microwave, and just dealing with all the anxiety that comes with coming back to school. Being a parent isn't an easy task. I'm a middle schooler myself, and I know that the past years have been a roller coaster, and there are many time robbers that are placed onto you guys through practices, going here and there. You're more of an Uber driver than you are a parent at times. My hope is that you feel like you've been communicated with, and you've been a good partner with you during your child's education experience here at MS. I'm sure if you sit here tonight, at least once it's crossed your mind, where has the time gone? It wasn't that long ago that we were getting on the bus to go to kindergarten. I came up with a Dora backpack that may have been used. I'm not sure if that's true or dated or not, but time does fly by fast. And as these kids go off to high school, they're going to be making memories and doing all sorts of crazy things and going this way and that. And I just encourage you to take the time to breathe, take a look at what they're accomplishing, and engage with them. Be a part of their lives. Even when they're pushing you away, take time to ask them how their day was and follow along as they go on this journey. To our faculty and staff, I gotta thank you for all you do for our students. From our cafeteria staff, our custodians, the instructional assistants, our front office ladies, Mary, Erin, Michelle, they all go the extra mile to help our students achieve success every day. And thank you to our student support team, our very busy nurse, Ms. Carpenter, right? Some days are very crazy around here this year. Ms. McGann, our Dean of Students, and Ms. Fair, Assistant Principal, as well as our social workers, Ms. Phelan, Ms. Parjanai, and Ms. Laporta. And of course, Mr. Woodward, our school psychologist. All these people put in a lot of time and effort behind the scenes to make sure your students are supported here during their days in the McKinney Middle School. Most importantly, and above all, I gotta make sure I thank our amazing teaching staff here at UMS. The students of McKinney are super lucky to have you, so let's give them a round of applause. All right, to the class of 2022. I hope you guys believe in yourself half as much as we believe in you. I hope you aren't afraid to make mistakes. You are capable of so much more than you give yourself credit for. There's going to be bumps in the road. There's going to be some embarrassing moments. But just remember, those are really important times. You can learn from those bumps in the road. And those embarrassing moments will become some of your best memories when you look back on them. Don't be afraid to laugh at yourself. You're gonna goof up. It's okay. Sometimes you guys put too much pressure on yourself. It creates that anxiety and that stress. But just know that you have people in your lives then it'll help you through things. The speakers talked about answering questions. Yeah, we had a lot of questions to answer the past year, and sometimes we didn't know the answers right away. But you know how we got through those times? We were together. That's why we had Trojans together on t-shirts. And once a Trojan, always a Trojan. If you guys ever need anything, you know where to find us. I hope you always remember to do your best every day. I hope you remember to be nice. You've heard that for 3 straight years, right? But I sincerely hope you enjoyed your experience at MS. I hope you learned life lessons, academic lessons along the way. But most importantly, I hope you have some memories to take with you. I hope you can look back at your yearbook. I hope you guys wrote appropriate things in them today. Let that hang for a minute. But I hope you look back at those yearbooks 3, 4, 5 years from now, maybe when you're graduating high school, and you can look back at some fond memories of your time here at MS. From preschool to now, your families, your teachers, the larger community in McHenry have helped you in ways that you may not be able to appreciate right now at this moment. But I want you to remember to be kind to people and be appreciative of all the things that people do to help impact your life. Thank you are 2 powerful words. You can say it when people help you along the way. As I've said, there's a lot of pride in this building tonight. I'm proud of the class of 2022, and I ask you guys to be proud of yourself and what you've accomplished. I ask you to be proud to be an MS Trojan, and be proud to be from the community of McHenry. Take care, students. We will miss you. Some of my favorite memories of the year are when students come back and want to come in the building and say hi to their teachers. We want to know how you guys are doing, and we may not say it enough, but I hope our actions speak louder than words. We care about you guys. And we wish you the best and brightest future that life can still bestow upon you. Thank you. All right. At this time, I'd like to recommend the class of 2022 for promotion to high school. Please welcome District 15 Superintendent Dr. Josh Heitz.
Thank you, Dr. Glover, for the presentation of the class of 2022. And it is a pleasure to act upon your recommendation and that of the faculty that these young persons be promoted to their freshman year of high school. And now, by the power vested in me by the Board of Education, I do here and now declare these students of McHenry Middle School to be graduates with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereto appertaining. Congratulations, class of 2022. Thank you.
Butler. Caitlin Lisa Bird. Marissa Christine Calabrese.
Yeah.
job, everyone. Families, we are going to dismiss all the graduates to our small gym and cafeteria area. So I ask that you please remain seated while we dismiss all of our students here. And now, on behalf of the faculty and staff of the McKinney Middle School, we wish you all success in high school in the many years to come. It's with great pride I present to you the McKinney Middle School class of 2022 and the high school graduating class of 2026. Thank you so much, everyone. Have a great evening.